The distributive property says, for any real numbers a, b, and c, a times the quantity b plus c equals a times b plus a times c. Simplify 5 times the quantity 8 plus 6. We will first use order of operations. We add together what's inside the parentheses first, 8 plus 6, that gives us 14. So therefore we have 5 times 14, which is equal to 70. Now we will use the distributive property. In the distributive property, we will multiply 5 times 8, and 5 times 8 is 40, plus we do 5 times 6, and 5 times 6 is 30, and 40 plus 30 equals 70 also. We will use the distributive property mainly because y and 1, these are not like terms, so we cannot add together y plus 1 inside the parentheses. The distributive property allows us to take 4, multiply it with y, and 4 times y is written 4y, plus 4 times 1, which is 4. We will use the distributive property mainly because inside the parentheses 9a and 4 are not like terms. We cannot combine those together. 9a plus 4 is not 13a, for example. Using the distributive property, negative 2 times 9a, let's write that out. And then we'll simplify the next line. Negative 2 times 4. Negative 2 times 9a is negative 18a plus negative 2 times 4 is negative 8. Our final answer usually does not contain plus a negative sign. We write instead negative 18a minus 8. We will use the distributive property mainly because inside the parentheses 3c and 7, those cannot be subtracted because they are not like terms. Notice that this negative sign in front of the parentheses is equivalent to writing negative 1 times the quantity 3c minus 7. I think we see better now what we distribute. We distribute the negative 1 times 3c, and negative times positive, negative 1 times positive 3 is negative 3. Negative 1 times positive 3c is negative 3c. Then we have negative 1 times, we should treat this as negative 7. Negative times negative is positive, so negative 1 times negative 7 is positive 7. Negative 3c plus 7 is our answer. We will use the distributive property mainly because inside the parentheses 8x and 5 are not like terms. We cannot combine them. We do not have 13x inside the parentheses. We need to use a distributive property. We have 3/5 times 8x. And that 8x we can write as 8x divided by 1. Plus 3/5 times 5. And 5 being a whole number, we can write as 5 divided by 1. Now let's simplify. The rule for multiplying fractions is to multiply through the numerators. 3 times 8x is 24x. And multiply through the denominators. 5 times 1 is 5. We can do the same with the second multiplication of fractions. 3 times 5 is 15. Multiplying through the denominators, 5 times 1 is 5. Is there any more simplification? Not in the first fraction. 24/5 does not simplify, so we still have 24x divided by 5. But 15/5 is equivalent to 15 divided by 5, which is 3. We will use the distributive property to simplify. -3/4 times 6h. Let's figure out the sign. Negative times positive is negative. So we have -3/4 times 6h divided by 1. 6 is a whole number coefficient, so we can write divided by 1. Continuing to distribute, we have a negative times a negative. That's a positive. So we will write positive 3/4 times 8/9 k. Now in this next step, we will do the fraction work. The rule for multiplying fractions says to multiply through the numerator. -3 times 6h is -18h. Multiplying through the denominators, 4 times 1 is 4. Plus, multiplying through the numerators, 3 times 8k, this k is implied to be in the numerator. We have 24k divided by, multiplying through the denominators, 4 times 9 is 36. We now simplify fractions. 18 and 4 are divisible by 2. We divide each by 2. 18 divided by 2 is 9, so we have -9h in the numerator. 4 divided by 2 is 2. 24 and 36, each of those is a multiple of 12. We can divide each by 12. 24 divided by 12 is 2. 2k is in the numerator then. 36 divided by 12 is 3. Distribute in order to simplify. -1.3 times 7a. Negative times positive is negative. So we'll have -1.3 times 7a. Continuing to distribute, negative times negative is positive, so we have plus 1.3 times 0.4. Let's do the decimal work. 1.3 times 7. 7 times 3 is 21. Carry the 2. 7 times 1 is 7, plus 2 is 9. There is a total of one digit to the right of decimal or decimals. So we count back from the far right one place to locate our decimal. So our first term, we call this negative sign here. Our first term is -9.1a. We also have to multiply 1.3 times 0.4. 4 times 3 is 12, carry the 1. 4 times 1 is 4, plus 1 is 5. Skip a space, 0 times 3 is 0, 0 times 1 is 0. Let's add 2, 5, 0, reading them backwards. We have a total of two digits, 1, 2, to the right of decimal points. So from the far right, we count back two places, 1, 2, to locate our decimal. So we have plus 0.52.